What's up, everybody? Welcome back to Big Things Kentucky, our postseason basketball edition. What's going on with you, Quetz?
What's going on, Coach? Have no fear, Big Things here. I'm Coach Butte, my main man, Coach TB on the side. Coach Truck, what's good, sir?
Man, I just want to say, hey, everybody, thanks for this ride. This is our third anniversary, you know what I'm saying? We actually would have hit our first show was right before the NCAA tournament 3 years ago. Coach, man, 3 years, Coach. You got a favorite moment so far?
Lord, Coach, it's been tough. It's been like one of them rocky marriages. Sometimes I love you, sometimes I can't stand you. You leave the toilet seat up. You don't what's call it. You don't brush your teeth all the time. But it's been a fun ride, man. I enjoy having Coach TB on. That's my guy. We had Jay Tall working with us for a little bit. Any show we do, like I said, we have our guys on for Beyond the Game. I love all those shows. We have them on. They're my good dudes there. So, man, it's been a blast, man. We had growing pains. We've learned and stuff. It's been fun, man. It definitely is. Every day, every show, every week is a chance for us to grow and get better and learn. You know what I'm saying? So we're not trying to reinvent the wheel. We're just trying to put our spin on it.
Yes, sir. I will say, man, this COVID year, this was something special, but we've adapted and overcome as Heartbreak Ridge, Clint Eastwood, Yassel. We winning, we riding. But, man, you know, man, it's been great. I've enjoyed talking to a lot of these coaches and finding out that, you know, man, we got a nice little following, man. You know, I'm surprised when I talk to some of the coaches and they're like, yeah, I like your show. And, Coach, I don't appreciate, you know, who you riding with. You know, so, man, it's been great. Y'all stick with us, subscribe, watch us grow, because bigger things is coming.
Speaking of watch us grow, we had 950 subscribers, 50 away for Big Things at 1K. Please help us get there. We got to put together a prize pack. Coach, the stimulus is on its way, so we really going to give y'all some nice stuff. So please, please, please. Her gets 50, but Coach Fit is the stimulus on the video game or something. So get to us and we get you something nice. Looking forward to it, man. So it should be big. So big things. Get us to 1K. 50 away, baby. 50 away.
All right, Coach, man. Right now, we're in the postseason. We got the district tournaments going on. The top two teams from each district go to the regionals as we get ready for the Sweet 16, Coach. So I want us to take a quick little peek at Big Things District. Give our picks on who we think going to take the districts, Coach. Coach, man, let's start off with the ladies. For the 41st district, I think really, Coach, that's just going to come down the Great Crossings in Franklin County.
Yes, sir. I like it, too. I'm agreeing with you, Coach. Give me Franklin County coming out of there over Great Crossing. Up next, Coach, we got the 42nd district. We got Frederick Douglass and Sayre. Then you got Scott County. Most likely going to play Henry Clay. I like Scott County's girls coming out of this district, Coach. Go against Frederick Douglass.
Yeah, Coach, I agree with you on that one, Coach. I think that'll be the matchups in the final for that one, Coach. In the 43rd, we got, I think, Dunbar, Coach. I mean, Dunbar is just class of this one.
Yeah. This is Dunbar to lose. I think Lafayette advances, so give me Dunbar with Lafayette to win the 43rd district.
And the 44th?
We got the 44th, Coach. We got Model, Madison Central. We got Berea, Madison Southern. Give me Central and Southern playing for the championship. Give me Central to pull it out, Coach.
I think Southern. I like what my man's doing, Southern. We talked to the coach earlier this year. I think Southern's been a surprise all season. Look for them to keep it going, Coach. And that regional tournament, I mean, everybody's got to have their eyes on Dunbar and Franklin County, Coach.
Absolutely, absolutely. It got to be your favorites, Coach. Got to be your favorites.
All right, Coach. On the boys' side, what you got, Coach?
We got the 41st district, Coach. We got right now going on the 17th, which would be the day before this comes out. You got Western Hills versus Frankfort. I like Frankfort in that game. Then we got Great Crossing, most likely taking on Franklin County. I like Great Crossing in that game. Give me Great Crossing and Frankfort in the championship game. Give me Great Crossing coming out of the 41st, Coach.
I'm going to take you all the way up to – I'm going to take Frankfort taking this one, Coach. I think Frankfort's going to handle this one.
All right. We got the 42nd next, Coach.
Okay. We got Henry Clay and Scott County. I think that one's really a toss-up, Coach. I think either one of them teams could advance. And, of course, Frederick Douglass, our man Deshaun Jackson, has been balling. The team has been on fire lately. Give me Douglass coming out of that district. And give me Scott County, Coach.
Coles, I'm keeping it in the city. Give me Henry Clay and Frederick Douglass. I mean, Henry Clay beating Scott Cannon Wednesday night, taking on Frederick Douglass, and Frederick Douglass winning that one pretty easily. I love Frederick Douglass. Sean Jackson, you got a lot of talent over at young talent as well. I like Frederick Douglass, Coach.
All right, Coach. In the 43rd, Coach, we got my man Ben Johnson and the Lexington Catholic Knights doing big things, baby. And I'm going to tell you off the top, Coach, my dark horse, them Dunbar Bulldogs, beat them right before the big game. I like Dunbar Lexington Catholic coming out of this one, Coach.
Coach, I agree with you there. I like Dunbar Lexington Catholic. I like Lexington Catholic pulling this off, even though Dunbar beat them earlier. Yeah. Early this month, so that should be a good one, though. But I think Ben Johnson have a turnaround. Plus, they got the new addition to transfer in, so I like Catholic in that one too, Coach.
Yes, sir. And 44th, I think you got to go Madison Central, Madison Southern, with Coach Feldhaus, as he says, getting his team at full strength. Give me the Indians, Coach.
I agree with you. Everything you said there, Coach. Like Coach said, he's getting his team back. He's he kept playing games all last week to try to get his team to work mesh. So, hey, they may make a run come the regionals, Coach. Don't be surprised to see Madison Central maybe playing for the championship.
And as always, they got a cold, too. You know, I like them cold. My man Cole Brown doing a big thing. Let's go Indians, baby. Roll try. I got you, Coach Feldhaus. We win and we ride, dude.
That might have been the kiss of death, Coach. I'm sorry about that. Please don't blame Big Fat Kentucky. Massive Central fans, please put all your dislike, disdain for this man here, Coach Thomas Benoit.
Well, Coach, man, that sets up our regional round, which we'll talk about next week, give our picks for our region, which will get us ready for Sweet 16, man. Big games, you going to check out any district games? You going to try and hit any up this week, Coach?
Definitely want to see that Scott County Harry Clay game. Should be a big one, Coach. Hope we can get in and check it out. I love to see your Dunbar Bulldogs versus Catholic 2, the championship game. Hopefully,
yes, sir.
Thursday night. So that should be big.
My man, Coach Bew, had another event. He couldn't make it for this one. We talked to the Kentucky Middle School Football Association president, Mr. Adam Latham, about the middle school football and their big event coming up at the end of the month, the Battle of the Regions, where they're going to break the state up into different regions and have a tournament to see which region is the best. Here's our interview with Mr. Latham. Mr. Adam?
Doing good, sir. How you been?
All right, man. Man, first of all, you know, just kind of tell us how this the Kentucky Middle School Football Association came about.
Well, we officially formed in 2008. There was a big kind of a middle school coaches get together, if you will, at the Nike Clinic that year. And just kind of seeing that middle school football was done in many different ways across the state of Kentucky. And why was that, and how do we get that untrue? Everybody kind of play by the same rules, follow the same general guidelines, and then maybe it, you know, work out some way to where we can have some kind of postseason type tournament of some kind. And in 2008, that's what we did. You know, it was just a small little 8-team conference winners tournament, and we crowned our first champions, and we've exploded from there. Yeah, so we have a classification structure that's similar to how the high school does it. We basically go off of mail enrollment. The one thing we try to do, and sometimes KDE is helpful with this, sometimes not, if they get their population reports out to us in time, is we try to do the alignment every 2 years instead of 4. And by doing that, the goal is that if you do it, so for this year, 2021, every odd year is a realignment year for us, a reclassification. So it'll be last year's school numbers, which I'm sure are going to be a little difficult. Basically, you know, we try to have it to where, so for that case, if we use the 6th and 7th grade numbers for the 2020-21 school year, each year for the next 2 years, one of those classes should be in the building. And so it's about as accurate as you can get. I mean, there's big swings. You know, Corbin, as an example, is one of our teams that floats right on that D1, D2 line. And so, you know, for one cycle, they're D2. For one cycle, they're D1. there's a couple other schools that fall into that parameters. That's what we try to do. Is it the best system? Probably not. But, you know, for what we have. And we reevaluate that every 2 years and see what we can do, what we have to do.
One thing I do notice about this is, like, when we were doing the championship games, you start seeing the same schools, you know, like the Corbins of the world and the Boyle counties, you know what I'm saying? And then you also see them later on, you know, the high school teams also showing up in that. How much input or, I don't know, fanfare as the high school coaches do they give to you guys?
They do. Several of them do. And not surprisingly, those schools that you see a lot of, the high school coaches are, I won't say they're directly involved, mm-hmm. but they're the ones, we send surveys out to the high school coaches periodically. They're the ones that respond. Good input, bad input, just different things to think about. You know, we have an advisory committee that we put together. There's 30 people on it. We've got officials. We've got high school ADs. We've got middle school ADs. We've got middle school and high school coaches on it. We've even got trainers on it. So, you know, we got things that we discuss when there's times to improve football or things we've got to change and so forth. But there is a direct correlation with those that I think are actively, and I say actively, but involved and know what's going on in their programs at the lower level, that success starts at the lower level and rolls up through the high school. We are a membership, a paying dues type membership into the association. In the past, we've had one dues fee, and that basically everybody was a full member. With COVID and everything last year, things got crazy with everything in life, and everything had to adapt. And so we've now adapted to having basically two membership models. We have a full membership. It's a $300 membership fee, and that covers entry into our state tournaments, coaches getting into our coaches clinic for free, some other perks, and kids are eligible for everything we do. And then we have what we're offering is like a postseason only membership, which doesn't get you in state playoffs and some other things, but allows kids from those teams the opportunity that maybe those teams don't want to play in the playoffs, but they want to be a part of everything else. Gives those kids the opportunity to be on all the postseason teams we've done, you know, get into all the camps that we're getting ready to start doing this year. And just, you know, anything that we do allows as many members and athletes to be a part of it as possible.
Is this fee per school or is this like per school board?
It's per school. It's per school. But like if a school's got a 6th, 7th, and an 8th grade team, it covers all three teams.
Okay.
So it's basically by the school.
Now, we get asked a lot of questions from people around town. You know, we're just wondering, what is the deal with the Lexi? Yes, it sounds like it's more of a, it's up to the school board to join.
Yeah. In reality, we don't keep no one back from being a membership by any means, except the school board. Now, Fayette County has its challenges in just the size alone. Similar to JCPS as well. And, you know, we've had discussions. We had really good discussions going into the going out of 2019 and into 2020. And then, of course, with COVID, everything, you know, got crazy. But we're working on it with Fayette County. You know, last year Fayette County allowed some of their teams to be postseason members. I know we had some kids from EJ Hayes. I believe we had a Beaumont kid. We had a Crawford kid. I know we had a ton of Bryant Station kids on our Team Kentucky and coming up with our event in Battle of the Region. So, you know, that door's opened a little bit, you know. Mm-hmm. If they can't do the playoffs, hey, that's fine. You know, Fayette County's got their structure that works for them. That's great. But let's get these kids opportunity for some of the other stuff that we're doing. And, you know, that door's open. I think that door will continue. And, you know, one day we'll get them. We'll be there.
All right. Now, y'all have a big event coming up right now, the Battle of the Regions. Explain that to us, though.
Okay, so I got to get a little backstory before I can get into Battle of the Regions. But, you know, some of the events we've always done is, you know, we're 7-on-7s. We help with 7-on-7s. We do a coaches clinic normally around June of every year. This year, we're going to start up combines and camps. Something we realized last year in having to do non-contact tryouts was we had a really big response to the three or four that we did, and a lot of these kids have never been through a combine or any kind of camp like that. So what we realized is we need to do more of those, but let's do them in season, you know, where these kids are really into football. You know, we're going to try to do 2 in July, 2 in August, and 2 September, different locations throughout the state. We've actually got 5 of the 6 locations already mapped out. But to get these kids just to run through this stuff, you know, and we're going to do some things. We're going to pick some golden ticket kids that, you know, we're going to get, you know, free pass into our full contact tryouts in November for Team Kentucky and All-Star Classic. You know, it's something I think we can give back to the kids with our coaches. We've got a great set of coaches between All-Star Classic, Battle of the Regions, Team Kentucky, other coaches to just help out when we're in their locations that want to help out these kids. So it's a tremendous effort from everybody involved. And it's a great thing to do. Got a great response to it. We want to keep that going. Battle of the Regions came about really with everything changing last year and us having to push the playoffs way back into deep November. It got to be a time crunch for us to try to pull off the All-Star Classic Thanksgiving weekend. Basically, Battle of the Regions, what it is it's All-Star Classic type format that we do. But instead of having 50 of your best 8th and 7th graders get square off against the best other 50, let's break these teams down to regional base. So Western Kentucky, you know, Northern and Louisville, the Mid-Bluegrass Conference there. And then Central Kentucky and Northeastern Kentucky. And then Southern and Eastern Kentucky. Let's break these teams down into four regions where they can practice on a weekend for a couple weekends, get their stuff together, and let's put them together, come into town one weekend. Let's see who the best region in the state really is.
All right, Coach. So now, Lexington, what we region two? Is that
you guys are kind of weird. You're wondering what we call our gray lines.
Okay.
So that's really like you guys actually are right on the line of 2, 3, and 4.
Oh, okay.
But for Battle of the Regions, all the Lexington kids are on the Region 3 team. Okay. So you've got the Lexington kids with the Scott County kids, the Elkhorn kids from Franklin Ooh. County. But you also got them in with the kids out in Ashland, some okay. of the kids out Johnson Central. So, you know, I know that Region 3 team's all pumped. It's going to be a great event. Response to it has been great from the parents, from the players. If you've checked out our Facebook page at all or yeah. some of the coaches, what they've posted, some of the videos of practice. I know I was at Region 2 7th grade practice Saturday, and just the kids were just giddy as they could be to be putting on pads and just doing a little football. Okay. You know, in March, we had a little decent weather. They were just as happy as they could be to do it, and that's what we want. The excitement's there. I think this is going to be a really big event. But they actually practiced, like I said, last weekend on the 13th, and then they're going to practice again on the 20th this Saturday. And then they come in to game weekend on the 26th. We've got registration March 26th. And the 27th and the 28th, they're going to play. I got to do a big shout-out to Jessamine County Schools, East and West Jessamine High Schools. They're our host sites for the days. Mark Miracle and Michael James, the ADs there, they've been great to have us hosting this event there. And it's going to be exciting. The 8th grade games on Saturday, both of the 8th grade games are going to be at 11 a.m. on Saturday and Sunday. And on the 7th grade games are going to be at 1:30 in the afternoon. For those coming, got players playing, you know, our attendance is pretty good. And those that can't but want to watch, we are broadcasting the games. All 8 games will be live on our Facebook page. So you can check out the games there and watch them. It's going to be a great.
It sounds good. You got a favorite so far, Coach? I need to know who to root for.
Oh, man. Being I'm a Region 2, I live in Region 2. If I don't say Region 2, you know, that is the thing. Knowing a lot of these kids, a lot of them through Team Kentucky, I believe, if I'm not mistaken, I'd say 95% of our Team Kentucky kids are playing. Mm-hmm. The few that aren't have either, you know, some select AAU basketball or some other type of events mm-hmm. coming up, you know, and we understand that, you know. But it's weird because, you know, you could say one region's got a lot of the athletes, you know, and the skilled kids, but then another region's got a lot of the linemen, and then another region's got a lot of the defense, but then another region's really balanced out. So it's hard to say, like, you know, you could sit here and pick, and I bet you if you asked all my board members, they'd probably pick their region too. But I'll be honest with you, I'd say all of them are winners. You know, the goal of this was 320 kids. They get the
320?
320 between the two grades, 40 kids on each team. They get to play a little football in March. Think about that. Like I said, Battle of the Regions games will be on the Facebook page. The events are posted. They just got to be updated. And one key thing that nobody knows yet is who's playing who yet. And that actually happens Sunday night, March 21st, 8 p.m. Eastern time on the Facebook page. We'll have the draw show. We've got a couple interviews we're doing, and then we'll have the draw show. Everybody finds out together who's playing who, and then we'll be able to find out, you know, we're a week away, and who's the best region in the state.
Tell us a little bit about Team Kentucky. I know each year they seem to getting better and better as you guys have progressed through this tournament. How'd y'all do this last season?
We've done exceptionally well, specifically in the last 2 years. The last 2 years is the first time we've been able to get a 6th, 7th, and 8th grade down to Naples to the national finals, top 8 in the nation. All that credit goes to Bronson Gowdy. I'll give it to him 100%. He's our vice president of the association. He's the director of Team Kentucky. And it comes down to, you know, it's been a process. It's not been this quick turn. You know, it's been a 5-6 year process of doing from what we were just kind of putting a team together and going and playing some games to really making this a year long thing to put these coaching staffs together, to put, you know, to get the right type of kids to play the right type of teams that we're playing. You know, we've gone down there with really big kids and we've won and we've also lost because we're too big. We're not fast enough, you know? So we had to tweak the teams a little bit. I give our coaches that we've had the last few years, the coaching staffs have been tremendous, tremendous coach staff, middle school guys, high school guys coming down and just, they put the work and dedication into it to make it great. And I got to give it to the players, man. They've stepped up. You know, I've said arguably this year's sixth grade team is probably one of the best sixth grade teams we've had and put together. And that's kind of the big piece of this is if we can get a good team at the sixth grade level and roll it forward, you know, we can do. I mean, you know, sixth and seventh grade, I believe, got fifth this year in the tournament. Eighth grade played the national championship game against our rivals, GFL. And, you know, unfortunately, we didn't win. But those games with GFL are always a battle. And the kids played really hard. And you know, it was huge success. You know, we're in the door. One of our biggest problems was going down to Naples and never winning the first game. Eighth grade knocked that door down this year. And to give credit, sixth grade lost by one score and seventh grade lost by 2 points. So we were right there knocking on the door with all three teams. So we're getting there. We're going in the right direction. And it's going to be the near future that Kentucky's bringing home an FBU national championship.
It's one thing, my man, Coach Bue, couldn't make it today. But one thing he is always big on is how do we get Kentucky to compete nationally? And I do notice that since you guys have started, we're starting to see a lot more D1 signees. And a lot of these kids come from Team Kentucky. So I want to thank you guys for, you know, upping the level of playing Kentucky and the respectability of Kentucky in the nation, man. You guys do a wonderful job. I want to thank you for doing that. And we look forward to hopefully seeing much more Lexington into this as well, because I think it's just good for the whole state. What are some of the next events you guys have coming up outside of just the Battle of the Regions tournament?
Okay. Well, we are Coach Ray Lockwood. He's one of our directors. He's kind of in charge over the 7-on-7s. We're kind of in a little situation right now where UK normally holds their big 7-on-7, and that's kind of the end capper for the year in June. And they're still up on the air whether they're going to be allowed to do that or not. And so if they're not, you know, we're kind of starting to swing the fences of trying to say, okay, can we host one somewhere to give those teams kind of an end of the season big tournament like they're used to. Let's try to get back to normal. So that's kind of that next step. And then our coaches clinic director, Mark Payne, he's working on doing a one-day type clinic in the morning, doing three or four speakers, probably going to be on the Zoom like everything else is now, so that then that afternoon we can host our annual meeting probably in July, right the first weekend of the season or so, right as everybody's getting into football. And then from there we go into our playoff season, and we got those camps and combines coming up. And, you know, what's people think this is just a, you know, an August to December thing, and we've definitely made this a year-round thing.
Yes, sir. Well, thank you again, Mr. Latham, and man, good luck to you guys and the rest of these ongoing seasons. Keep doing big things for Kentucky and middle school football. We appreciate you coming on.
All right, thanks for having me,
man. Hey, hopefully we answer a lot of questions. We had a few people ask questions about participation and everything. Also, we'll know what's going on with Lexington eventually maybe joining this. Like you said, there's some problems and schedules and stuff they got to work out. But stay tuned for that. Man, come out to the event if you got it. We got a bunch of Lexington kids participating. It'll be taking place here.
Share, make sure you share, subscribe, and like Big Things Kentucky on YouTube. Make sure you holler at Coach Chuck and myself for the merchandise. We got the Big Thing, the state shirt. We got the Big Thing baby. Got a new shirt coming out soon, Coach. We got to go and break it out next week. Be looking for it. Coach has been a great 3 years, man. Looking for 33 more, hopefully. Somebody give us a check, man. We need some money. My wife, I need to get paid. Somebody give us something. Give us a job. Me and Coach do play-by-play for youth basketball, youth baseball. Somebody give us a check. Coach is ridiculous.
Also, any softball, baseball coaches want to get on rotation so we can get y'all in, hit us up on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram. We'll also be reaching out to you guys to set up stuff. Frederick Douglass Baseball, I know y'all been coming for us, baby. Get ready, Coach. Here we come.
All right. Coach, man, yeah, definitely. Coach Brooks has been on you, Coach. Get him on the show. I don't know why you don't put him on the show, Coach. I don't know what's going on. But Coach Brooks, I will make sure personally you get on the show. We'll get you taken care of, get you all here. Man, as always, you have to be a living donor. I'm Coach Bue. My main man, Coach T, be on the side. Coach Truck, anything else?